Hello aspirants, myself Keetana Bhusa. I have appeared for interview in 2018. We at Narayana IAS Academy have come up with economic survey module. We will be discussing each chapter separately. And economic survey is very important from mains perspective. Questions have been asked in the previous years from this survey directly. So please note all the important points to use it wherever they fit. And believe me, your economic part preparation will not be complete without having hold over this economic survey. Having said this, we'll discuss the fourth chapter of economic survey, data of the people, by the people and for the people. Recent reports suggest that there are 500 million internet users in India currently. And as people shift their day-to-day activities online, they leave a digital footprint. And this is the major source of all kinds of matter. Data, as the modern wisdom says, is the new oil. And India has lot of data with more people adding to digital world. And as more gets added, then more will be the mines of data. And now, as per the economic survey, is the time for India to utilize this valuable resource so that we can maximize the benefits to the society. Because the data is generated by the people, which is of the people, and so there is a need to utilize the data for the people. And the economic survey says that the data should be made a public good to maximize these benefits. So in this chapter, we look into the data explosion and its utility to the society. Why must be data treated as public good and the concerns regarding data privacy as well as applications. That is, who are going to get benefited of this data. So the first point is data explosion and its utility to the society. As per the economic survey, as more people are utilizing the digital services, this is leading to generation of data at unprecedented level. But at the same time, fortunately, the human skills, that is the human capital and the technical capital, both are emerging at the same pace so that we have the global digital infrastructure ready to handle this data, which is growing at unprecedented level. What happened as a result? The marginal cost of data declined. What does this marginal cost include? That is, generation of data, it includes four parameters: generation, storage, processing, as well as dissemination. The economic survey says that the generation, storage and dissemination involve very low cost. In fact, the generation of data, which is a very laborious task in 1980s, has become nearly free of cost now. And the storage, which was used to be nearly 61,000, has come down to 3 rupees. And dissemination is also a near free of cost. However, as per the economic survey, the processing is relatively high and is getting addressed with the evolution of technologies. So, now the data is ready and this valuable resource should be utilized to the optimum value. So, while the marginal cost of data is declining exponentially on one hand, on the other hand, the marginal benefit to the society increased manifold. The data, which is logically arranged, can enhance the ease of living, enable truly evidence-based policing and improve targeting welfare schemes and uncover the unmet needs of the society. It also leads to greater citizen participation and integrate fragmented markets, and the greater citizen participation is the test for the success of democracy. The next question arises, why must be data treated as public good as mentioned by the economic survey? Since the survey has mentioned that the marginal cost of data is decreasing and the marginal benefits to the society are increasing, there is a large scope of the optimum quantity of data that society can consume. And if it is true, then as per economic theory prediction, The economy should have by now seen surge in the efforts to harness and use the data. Has this happened? The answer is yes, but only partially. So, if at all there is a maximum benefit to the society, the economic theory prediction says that by now, this data has been, by now, we should have seen a surge in the efforts to harness and use the data. But partially, this is true. We are using the data. But here, the private sector endeavor is highest than ever before. As per Forbes report 2017, 53% of the private companies are making their decision using the big data. Companies such as Facebook, Google, they earn exclusively based on data. But can the private sector, which are profit-oriented, invest in the area where societies are getting maximum profit? The answer is no. So, many areas such as agriculture, education, data is not as ubiquitously harnessed and used. So, here there is a need for the government intervention because private investment is inadequate in the social sectors. And the private sector has done impressive job of harnessing some kind of data that can generate profit, and government intervention is required where private investment is inadequate. And to ensure that the socially optimum amount of data is harvested and used, the government must step in. The kind of data gathered by the government on the issues of social interest, that is, that data should be made public good, and the public good is non-rivalrous and non-excludable. Moreover, the data is generated by the people and the data is of the people and it should be used for the people, and this makes the case to make the data public good. So, what are the two cases that should be considered as a case to make the data as public good is that, one, the private sector intervention is not adequate in social sectors and this makes the government intervention required. As well as, since the data is generated by the people and of the people and it should be used for the people, hence it should be made a public good. At the same time, the concerns regarding data privacy should also be addressed. Few points are mentioned in the economic survey to ensure the data privacy, that is, utilization of data should be subject to user consent, and this is way we can protect the data, and people has the option to opt out of divulging data to the government wherever possible. The departments must take care to appropriately treat private data and public data with the standards they require. And immutable access logs for all data would be available to the citizens. That is, the citizens will come to know who at all are accessing their data. And an example of Telangana government's initiative Samagra Vedika, which links 25 data sets of different departments. At the same time, it has ensured that the data is not tampered by the department which is not concerned about the data. Suppose if the department is transport department, it can have access to the data of the citizen's name but cannot tamper it. So in this way, the economic survey says that the data privacy can be ensured. We also look into the economies of scale and scope in the data generation process. The data collected by the government of India can be divided into administrative data, survey data, transactions data and institutional data. But the problem here is that data collection in India is highly decentralized. If we have large amounts of data which is not logically arranged, cannot be put into the optimal use. Hence, in order for synergistic benefits to accrue, it must be motivated by three characteristics. That is, there is a need to combine disparate data sets, and there is a need to cover critical mass of individuals and firms, as well as data must have long enough time series to understand the dynamism. As well as, these three characteristics are important for the designing of policy, implementation, as well as to track the efficacy of the programs. And who is the first beneficiary? The government itself is the beneficiary. Being able to retrieve the authentic data and documents instantly, governments can improve targeting the welfare schemes and the subsidies by reducing both inclusion and exclusion errors. And private sector can too become the beneficiaries. The private sector may be granted access to select database for commercial use. There is no reason to preclude commercial use of this data for profit because it is inconsistent with the notion of data as a public good.
And the economic survey says that we can also sell these data sets to analytics agencies that process the data, and we can generate insights and sell the insights further to the corporate sector, which they can use to predict demand, discover untapped markets, or innovate new products. So there is a tremendous scope for the private sector to benefit from the data, and they should be allowed to do so, not at free of cost but at a charge.
And the economic survey says that fortunately stringent technological mechanisms exist to safeguard data privacy and confidentiality even while allowing the private sector to benefit from the data. So it is saying that there is no need to worry while we are giving our data sets to the private sector, because the stringent technological mechanisms are there to safeguard data privacy as well as confidentiality. And the final and the most important beneficiary is the citizen. And the economic survey has given the example of DigiLocker, which makes all the documents of the citizens available in a verified format in one place on the cloud. So the benefits of creating data as a public good can be generated within the legal framework of data privacy, and going forward, the data and information highway can be viewed equally as the infrastructure as physical highway, and this can help India leapfrog to utilize the benefits of technological advances for welfare of its people. Not to forget that India has committed for the welfare of its citizens. The preamble as well as directive principles of state policy mentions the same. Hope this video is helpful. Thank you and all the best.